there is an inherent risk for everyone who is living to have seizures. So, and if you do the wrong things, so these are called kind of the provoking factors. So if it's an isolated seizure event, you may not have epilepsy. It may be a one-time event. And the common provoking events for seizures would be use of stimulant medications or drugs, excessive alcohol use, or it can even be certain electrolyte abnormalities or something that can cause this abnormal electrical discharges from the brain. In terms of epilepsy, epilepsy is diagnosed when someone has recurrent seizures without these provoking factors. What we find is when we order additional tests, including use of EEG, electroencephalogram, and studies like MRI of the brain, this would be to look for areas of abnormality which could have triggered the seizure episode. This can be then controlled with the use of medications to make sure these discharges don't spread and they are in check, so then the patients do not end up having more seizures. One of the things we do through our clinic is do something called an ambulatory EEG. So that's a longer term recording. And then you can go home with that. And then they're continuously monitoring the brainwave activity for up to 72 hours. And in terms of patients who have recurrent seizures in the field or outside the hospital, they're coming with newer ways of administering some of these emergency medication, which only used to be given in the hospital setting.